What's up, guys and gals, fellow YouTubers? It's Dan Donovan again with another video coming from my room this time. So it's gonna be actually like my workshop, but you know, actually we're gonna be doing some work in the kitchen and stuff. Anyway, today's video is on do-it-yourself pork stuff. All right, and I particularly have an idea that I haven't seen out there yet, and I've been doing a lot of research on this. These pork planters, you know, you carve it out, put your little air plant in there, and put a magnet, and then it sticks on your fridge, and it's pretty cool, you know, real pretty, bring some life to the kitchen, you know, if you can't cook, especially. But, yes, today I'm going to be making one for the girl whom I love, whose birthday is coming up, so it's going to be like a birthday present. And she's quit talking to me, so hopefully this might get her to talk to me. I don't know. I'm trying everything. Sounds desperate, but you know. What you'll do for love, right? Hey, you know. So, yeah. Keep following me out there. You're going to learn a cool way to do this. Especially if you're interested in doing this. It's going to be, you know, I'll show you detailed steps you have to take in order to get it right. Because, you know, I haven't seen anything as detailed as what I'm going to show you.
We're gonna be making this thing, and I think it's pretty cool. You can do this with like anyone's name, and I haven't seen anything else out there like that, so that's what this video is about today. What's up, y'all? All right, so this cork right here sucks. It's a recyclable plastic cork. That's a good cork. You want the good corks because you want to inscribe with your wood burner on there. Okay, you're going to need this glue gun, you're going to need this wood burner to, you know, inscribe letters with. You're also going to need your, a sharp knife. For instance, I have this Leatherman, I love it, I've had it forever. Alright, so, you want to pre-cut these things. Now be careful with this knife, it's easy to cut yourself on this thing. You know, kids, if you're a kid watching this, make sure you got, you know, your parents with you when you're cutting. So you want to pre-cut these things to size, so you can fit more dirt and soil in there so your plants can grow better. And so that's why you're prefabbing there. Okay, what I'm going to do here is kind of like put together a little model of what I'm going to make. I have six corks in the background there, and that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 corks for the letters, because there's five letters in Emily. So here we go, we're going to put those corks up in there, and this is just kind of like showing y'all what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a little bottom bracket on there, just coming up here, yeah, so that's just to add support, and so the corks don't come out of there so easy, and you'll see another reason why. That 1994 cork, that's going to be really important to the piece that I'm making. It's the year she was born. It's just going to add a little bit more customization to it. These are my pre-cut pieces, my prefab pieces. This is my little bottom bracket with a little cool wax piece at the end there. And there's my name, a little secret message to my beloved, with the little heart and the arrow coming through it. You like that, huh? Yeah, so that's my bottom bracket. Okay, what I'm going to do is glue these things one by one on here very carefully and precisely. Going one at a time, really. So I just make everything perfect and right, or not perfect, but you know, almost do as best as I can. And I'm also gonna change camera views on y'all, because that was getting weird. All right, so here we go. One by one, I'm taking these pieces, these corks, and just getting them on there just right, you know, the perfect level, height, you know, whatever. You also be careful with this glue gun too. That hot glue will burn you. And be aware of where you're putting these corks. You know, I want that 2014 to be there on the end. You know, that's the year we met. And you know, just adds a little coolness to it, makes it special. So yeah. And, oh yeah, there's my little bottom bracket with my little secret message. Yeah, I like that wax. Anyways, so here we go. I'm gonna put some glue on the bottom of that and make sure that it is in there snug and fit exactly where I want it. Bam, nice. Okay, It's looking like it's coming together here. Oh, once again, that 1994 cork, very important. Keep that thing somewhere to where, you know, it's, you're not gonna lose it. And start heating that wood burner up, because you're gonna need that as well. Look at all that thing, and look at that thing. That's the back bracket, the back piece. Pretty much gonna have nice space for soil and stuff. Okay, in this, you also wanna test out your wood burner, you know, get used to it, you know, get some other corks and just kinda like play around with it, get to where, you know, you're gonna write some stuff. So this is the first Y that I chose. I'm gonna draw two Y's in this video, because and one of them I don't like, that would be this one, and that's why I'm drawing the other one. But I didn't have time to edit this out, but yeah, that's the first Y. And I think it's just, it doesn't fit the rest of the letters. So I'm gonna end up doing a different Y. All right, so what I'm doing pretty much here is just kind of putting the letters all together, seeing what it's looking like. And yeah, there we go, Emily. So all right, once again, one by one, you wanna glue these pieces on one by one. So just so you make sure that you got, you know, them in the right position. So there's the E. I'm gonna right here. There's the M. I'm also even letting it dry a little bit before I put the other one on there. You don't want to put too much glue on this part, because it's gonna be the face and what people are gonna see. And I don't know, you just don't want globs of glue looking around, you know. Okay, so here we are. I'm fitting that I on there, and I'm getting to the L. Here we go. You know, L. Nah. Anyways, I'm getting bored. All right. So next, I think this is when I decide to make a different Y, because I'm not happy. Oh, look at all the space up in there for that dirt. Oh yeah. I'm gonna have big plants coming up out of here. I don't know. Maybe. This is, you know, it's kind of experimental. Anyways, okay, so oh yeah, you see the holes? Bam. You're gonna have to put some glue up in there. So alright, here we go with the second Y that I decided to make for the last letter. It's more of a conventional Y. It's gonna fit the rest of the letters. I was trying to get too fancy with that last one, but here we go with this one, and I'm really happy how it turned out. And yeah, it's really looking good. Hopefully I can, hopefully she'll be happy. And so here we go. Here's some adding this last letter to the piece. I'm gonna put that glue on there, and then voila. All right, what else? What's next? What we got going on here? Oh yeah, that 1994 cork. We're gonna put that right there in the middle, and that's really, I thought that was really cool. I don't know, I just kind of came up with this one. I saw, you know, the plant planters. Oh, look at that, looks good, huh? Yeah, I was like, I can do a better job. Oh yeah, what's up, y'all? Hey, that's me. Oh, secret message. Yes, hope you get that there, girl. Look at that. See all the space up in there? Alright, here we go. I'm also going to cut a cork in half and add it to each end of that 1994 cork. It'll just look a little better. You know, what do you think? I like it. Cool. Alright, next, it's magnet time. I'm just going to, you know, pretty self-explanatory, put these magnets on the back there. You know, use your hot glue gun. And that's the easy part. Really, the hard part's kind of past us, cutting all that out, all those corks, and we still got to put the plants in there too. That kind of sucks, but it's fun too, though. You know, yeah, I'm all about my garden. That's what I do. You know, I got an awesome garden. Y'all will see some of my garden on my YouTube channel. Oh, look at that space. Yeah, that's gonna be really nice. Oh, girl, I hope you like that. Yeah, it's ready. Just gotta put some plants up in there. There they go. Love those plants. I like that pretty. And look at that pretty. It's like little trees. I don't know what it is, though. On the right, that's what I'm talking about. I like that one too, though. The purple one. Yeah, it's cool. Love the color purple. That is, wow, exotic angel tree. Okay, so here we go. Let's put these plants up in here. It's really kind of, more difficult than I thought. Whenever you're cutting these plants, make sure that, you know, we'll first put some dirt up in there, but when you want to cut them, make sure you got some roots on the end of that plant when you're putting that plant in there. That's, you know, the plant needs roots. You can't just cut a stem off and stick it in there. With some plants, you can do that. I don't know which ones, though. I don't know if these are them either. But, yeah, so I'm just carefully, you know, placing these things. But once again, with this plant, the same thing. Make sure you get some roots in whatever you cut, you know, and some of that good soil that comes with it. So there we are with the second plant, and I'm just going to kind of stuff it in there. And there goes my favorite one. We're gonna find a little nice little tree come off there. Yeah, I know where to cut that thing. Bam, right there. Got him. All right, yank it on out. Just, you know, make sure them roots are there. Ooh, look at all them roots. Too many. It's all good, though. You know, strong roots. It's what you need. So we're going to tuck that thing in there. And, yeah, I just put a little bit of dirt on there. And, yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed this. Tell me what y'all think. You know, subscribe, like, or dislike, or, you know, don't subscribe. Just, you know. I like real results, and you know, y'all tell me what you think. I haven't seen anything like this when it comes to these planters, so you know, hopefully I'll be the first one on YouTube with it. So here we go, you know, there's the finished product. Thanks for watching, y'all, once again. Oh yeah, you know, there we go. The final message would be that I love Emily, and you know, hey, peace out, y'all. Y'all be good now. Till next time. Peace.